But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continueth therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed.
For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. So he's saying here, hey, what I have received is what Jesus gave. What we are doing, what we are teaching is the same thing that the Lord Jesus Christ did with his church. He's just continuing it. He's confirming it. And you know, he says, hey, there's going to be heresies. There's this warning here. And so there is a warning, because listen, today there is a Catholic conspiracy to corrupt communion. That what they do is not biblical, and yet it seems to have some of the symbology, it seems to have some of the similarities. So there's a warning here that there are heresies of the Lord's Supper, and God wants us to understand the distinction between the things, and we need to use the Bible as a litmus test. It's only the Bible that can cut through the misunderstandings. So Paul was setting these things in order. He's trying to tell them, hey, you need to follow Christ's example, because the way they were doing it was wrong. They were doing it in the wrong manner, in the wrong spirit. And so Paul had to correct them and set it in order, right? Jesus, you know, he said that he must keep the Passover. So he was really continuing that Passover. But as we know that he was the Passover, the Lord Jesus Christ was our Passover lamb. And so we don't eat lamb when it's time to do the Lord's Supper or the Lord's table. You know, we continue what came after that, which was the days of unleavened bread. Now, the leaven was a picture of sin. So what we do is, hey, we get the sin out of our life. We break bread. We remember what the Lord Jesus Christ did for us. And, you know, meanwhile, there are many heresies out there. The Catholics have hijacked Christianity. The Catholics are fake Christians. And most of your pre-Vatican II Christians would even say, well, I'm not a Christian, I'm a Catholic. They would make that distinction. Whereas today with this ecumenical movement, hey, everybody's a Christian. You know, we are universally Christian and there is no hell. Everybody gets to go to heaven. And listen, those things are not true. Those things are a lie. And what the Catholic Church does with all their attire, just the garb, the vestments, the Bible clearly warns us about the pagan vestments. I mean, they dress up as, you know, basically what the Roman judge or the Roman cops look like way back in the day. And that's where they get their garb. And they pretend like they are something or somebody. They're prestigious and they have authority. But guess what? They have no authority. According to the scriptures, they're not even children of God. In fact, most of the people that work for the Catholic Church are children of the devil. They are deceivers. And what they do that they call communion, you know, they even take another name. We call it, the sacrament of the Eucharist, right? And then they take what is the Lord's Supper, the Lord's table, and they take pieces of it and they pervert it and they present it in a different way. You know, they call it a mass. A mass, you know, the word has a few origins, but it all goes back to the same thing. It's talking about, like a dismissal when somebody died. A mass is actually a death ritual. And listen, when the Catholics go through this conspiratorial communion, if you will, because they conspired to pervert the scriptures. They came together in secret. They said, we're going to establish our pagan government. We're just going to call it Christian, right? So when they hijacked Christianity, they conspired against Christ. They conspired against communion. They said, we'll take all the symbology. We'll bring it in. We'll do a death ritual and we'll kill Jesus again every time. Every time we do the communion, they are literally killing Christ yet again, as if his sacrifice was not enough. So there's a lot of misunderstandings about communion. Most of it actually stems from the Catholics or even the Orthodox Church or even the Protestants, those that broke away from the Catholics just to protest the Catholic Church to try to reform it. So your Protestants, your Reformers, your Catholics, you know, most of those, they are not even Christians. They are trusting in their own works to get to heaven. Their doctrine comes from men and not from God. And so, of course, they have perverted baptism. We all know that. And we're not going to get into that too much today. But they've also perverted communion. They've perverted the Lord's Supper. And I want to help cut through some of that and make it clear from the Bible. I want to read to you what the Catholics say when they keep the Eucharist sacrament. The priest first will hold up a cup and they call the host. They have a wafer. It's not unleavened bread all the time. It's a wafer and they call it the real presence of Jesus, right? That is the Holy Ghost, they'll even call it. And, you know, they try to, you know, we talked about the solar monstrance. It is a sun, a golden sun as an idol that they will put the host in, and they'll adore it, and they'll say, this is God. And they're worshiping the sun. The Bible warns in Exodus about worshiping the sun, the moon, the stars, and other gods. Well, that's all the Catholics are about, are worshiping devils. They worship other gods, and they want to trick the world into thinking that they're finding the real God. You know, they want to trick the world into thinking that the Catholic priests, they can become saints and they achieve perfection, but you lowly people never can. You just need to keep coming closer to us and following us. And they make it very difficult to understand what they're doing. And they use very mystical pagan symbology throughout the entire process. So the priest will hold up the host, you know, which is the bread, and the cup, and the priest says, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Now, think of it. They're holding up a wafer and they say, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. They're holding it, all right, and it may not be leavened. It can be leavened or unleavened. They don't care. It doesn't matter to them. But they do use alcoholic wine. They will hold up fermented, corrupted wine and say, this is God. This is the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. They say, these things take away sins. And they go through a process, and you want to take your sins away? Come down to me and you can receive that forgiveness by taking these things. They say, this is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. And then the congregation responds, Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. Now, this is a perversion of what was said in Matthew chapter 8 about saying, you know, saying, Lord, I'm unworthy to receive you in my house. Only say the word and thy servant shall be healed, you know. So, I mean, they actually pervert scriptures and they mash these scriptures together to come up with this. So it sounds godly. It sounds like it comes out of the Bible, but they're perverting things. But notice, everyone that takes this Eucharist, this Catholic communion, they say, I am not worthy to receive you.
That's right.
Hey, I say amen. They're not worthy because they're not saved. They don't believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, so they are not worthy of his supper, of his table. And it's very wicked what they're doing because they're perverting what Christ did, what he said. Hey, remember me when you do this. Make this a memorial that you do every year.